Hey there, VSDC family! We've seen your questions about the key editor and how to create smooth animations with keyframes. Well, today's your lucky day because this is the full tutorial you've been waiting for. Everything you need is right here, so let's dive in. The key editor is the place where you create keyframes to animate anything. Movement, size, color, whatever you want. There are two main types of keyframes. Value keyframes, which are used for numbers and measurements, and color keyframes for animating color changes. Let's take a curve line as an example. First, add it to the timeline, then go to the properties window. If you see three little dots next to a parameter, that means you can animate it. Just click the dots and the key editor will open with all the available settings. By default, the parameter is set to constant parameter value, which means nothing will change over time. To animate it, you'll need to switch the mode. There are a couple of ways to do that. One option is to expand a property, like thickness, and set a starting value, say, to 1, and an ending value, like 6. That alone will switch the mode to linear, and the animation from 1 to 6 will be created automatically across the object's duration. Another way to change the mode is to do it manually. In the Properties window, you can right-click the mode icon to choose a different one, or left-click to cycle through the options. Inside the Key Editor, click the triangle next to the mode icon to open a drop-down list. The first two modes are available in the free version, while the rest require Pro. Let's go through these modes quickly. Constant parameter value means the property stays the same the entire time. Linear parameter change lets you create a simple animation between two points with no extra keyframes in between. Starting from the next mode available already in Pro, you can add intermediate keyframes and create more flexible animations. To do that, just move the cursor to the right spot and click the diamond button. Press Insert or double-click. You can enter precise values using the input field above the graph. The parameter change along a curve mode adds automatic smoothing between keyframes, but you can't adjust the smoothing strength. It's great when you need quick, natural transitions without spending time tweaking the graph. For full control, there's the Bezier curve mode. You can drag the handles to shape the animation however you want. To move just one handle, hold Ctrl while dragging. There is one more setting called Path Properties. It is used when you want to force linear interpolation after a certain keyframe, even in advanced smoothing modes. Just select the keyframe, click Path Properties, choose Last Point of Trajectory, and then go back and select Linear Parameter. It is a simple way to switch a section of your animation to linear in one go. If you are already in Bezier mode, there are some great shortcuts. Ctrl plus double-click changes any keyframe between smooth and linear, and Ctrl plus drag brings back the Bezier handles if they're missing. Navigating between keyframes is also easy using the arrow buttons at the top. If you want to move a point up, down, or sideways, just hold Shift while dragging. You can also move the entire curve up or down without holding anything. Now, let's talk about copying and pasting keyframes. Click Copy Points and open another tab in the Key Editor where you want to paste the keyframes. Then click the triangle next to the Copy button and choose Paste Point. Keep in mind that this works with the full set of keyframes. Individual key copying isn't available. To keep things organized, you can rename tabs. Just right-click the tab title and select Rename Tab. The name will stay even after closing and reopening the project. If you want to see multiple parameters at once, enable Show Parameter. This lets you display several graphs in the same window and quickly switch between them by clicking the curves. If you change the duration of an object, the Key Editor will keep the spacing between keyframes by default. But there are two other options you can try. One stretches only the last keyframe, and the other stretches only the first. These are really helpful if you want to extend an object without breaking your animation. You can delete individual keyframes or clear them all at once. Now, let's move on to templates. These are great for speeding up your workflow. You'll find them in the template section of the Key Editor. Some templates generate multiple keyframes following a specific pattern, while others only work with two Bezier keyframes. If you want to invert a template before using it, just hold Ctrl while selecting it. Templates are also available directly in the Properties window. Just right-click the graph icon and pick the one you need. Templates like zigzag, rectangle, and sinusoids lets you set minimum and maximum values, adjust frequency, phase, and durations to build detailed animations. The fading sinusoid template takes it further by letting you create fading or intensifying waves. You can align them, control the fade-out effect, and even add randomness to make the animation feel more organic. There is also a parameter randomization option that lets you instantly create natural-looking variations in your animation. One of the most useful templates is called Edit the Beat. It synchronizes animation with the music. First, place your audio file under the object you want to animate. Then pick the Edit the Beat template and select the audio file. Choose the sensitivity preset that controls how the tool reacts to the sound. Use the Create Points button to preview the animation. You can also narrow it down by selecting a frequency range. Pay special attention to four settings here. Silence value sets the minimum value of the animation. Amplitude controls the maximum. Minimum affects how many keyframes get created. And scale factor changes the overall strength of the animation. Do not forget to hit Create Points after every change to preview the result. Now, let's finish with color animation. Create another curve line and find the pen property. Click the three dots to open the Key Editor, just like before. Color animation doesn't support templates or the curve mode, but otherwise it works the same way. Double-click the color swatch to choose an exact shade, or drag it up and down to cycle through colors. The Bezier mode works here too. Just switch to it, then Ctrl plus drag any keyframe to add handles and smooth the color transitions. And that's it! We've covered everything you need to know about the Key Editor. If anything is still unclear, leave your questions in the comments. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.